I'm now working with a graduate student who is the graduate mentor from this year's Data Plus project, who works with fan fiction. And she can download entire corpuses of one specific type of fan fiction based on a TV show or a novel and teach one course as the instructor of record and teach her to her own students how to fully analyze maybe 10,000 fan-produced texts at once.
I took a class with Astrid and it was quite wonderful. It had nothing to do necessarily with anything computational. She turned me on to this fellowship that was going to happen, and the fellowship really opened some doors in terms of making me believe that I could learn how to code. I think it's one of those things where you get really far into a PhD in English and it's like, I don't know that coding is something I could pick up. It is something I could pick up and that I got good at enough to put into my dissertation. And from there to be able to lead a project and help students also create their own research using computational methods while all still in our great home of English.
Anna Jorgensen is the first fellow to have finished the Rhodes iiD Computational Humanities Fellowship. She's currently the mentor for my Data Plus project, but over the past 4 years, she has been collecting texts online from fan fiction websites. She has been analyzing them in bulk for her dissertation, but also designing a unique and novel course to teach undergraduate students how to mine this website, collect a corpus, organize it, and analyze it with large data methodologies. What she's doing, it's really innovative because she really has to figure out both the questions to ask out of this text because this is a brand new genre.
I have, you know, there are professors and faculty that are working around this, and Astrid teaches courses that incorporate a lot of the computational methods. It's a field in formation, and so the canonical readings are still sort of being hammered out, and so she was really great at picking out the ones. It narrowed down the field to say, okay, let's read these and discuss these, and kind of an entree into the field in a really nice way. But then also giving us some tools to actually practice with. So I was able to build my practice corpus and then practice with all of these different tools that she introduced us to. And then I was able to kind of roll all of that in and teach my own undergraduate course with some of the things that I had just learned. So it was easier than trying to build it from scratch myself and trying to figure out how am I going to teach this. She gave me some really good starting programs to carry over into the course.
She has to understand, is this imitation, is this pastiche, or is this something completely new and innovative? These are texts that also undergraduates are already familiar with. A lot of students are excited to read and participate in the creation of fan fiction themselves. So they naturally want to engage with this form of both creative writing, but also textual analysis. But because of the just vastness of the corpora online, Hannah had to come up with some really clever ways to get the data, organize it, clean it, and prepare for analysis in a way that would be very much accessible to undergraduates during a semester. I've seen her put together step by step her project where she comes up with categories of analysis. Texts that are creating fan fiction of a novel or the TV version of a novel different? Do they rely more on description if they're based on characters that they have seen in a TV show versus having to imagine a character just by reading about them? How can we quantify that idea of the description of a character? What aspects are important? Is it the clothing, the face, the color of hair? Those were all questions that she had to navigate and find ways to translate from a conceptual question into something that is quantifiable and measurable and can be done by undergraduates. So learning this for the very first time, which is quite difficult.
I'm also a project manager in Data Plus for the Ethical Consumption Before Capitalism project. Several summers in, and this summer I get to be a part of it. being able to say that I could direct a team doing things that I don't actually know, maybe everything that they're doing, right? Like, I don't have to know how every single piece of their code works. I feel like I can manage a team and give them enough guidance to get where they need to go and where I would need a team to go, and without micromanaging the thing, right? Which is exciting, because someday I would like to be able to have a team that could do the research for me and be able to let the team do it and let it go and know that they're going to be able to figure out how to do it in a way that they're still being guided and we're all figuring out what our research question is. Yeah.
So if you're an English major who absolutely loves reading novels and is curious about fan fiction and how it's related to traditional novels, this is a good way to do the kind of writing you would do in an English class and to learn a new skill. And if you're a computer science or stats major who wants to dabble into literature, here is a welcoming course that will say, yes, use your skills, bring them in to an English course. I'm pretty sure that Hannah's course was overflowing and had a waiting list, which is quite unusual for English graduate students teaching for the first time.
As far as I know, I'm maybe one of the, not the first graduate student, but being able to offer this out to students, I think, is really exciting.